Hello everyone. In this video, we are going to discuss a very important type of reactions called elimination reactions. So as you can see, as the name of the reaction suggests, some molecules are getting eliminated in this reaction. So elimination reactions are nothing but those reactions in which two atoms or groups are removed from the molecule to give us a final product. This reaction is actually opposite to addition reactions. And why is that? We saw in addition reactions that an unsaturated starting reactant gives us a saturated product. In elimination reaction, a saturated starting reactant gives us an unsaturated product, that is, the product essentially contains multiple bonds. Let's look at an example which is given here. In this reaction, we have a starting reactant which is CH3CH2Br, and this reactant, when treated with a strong base like KOH, results in the elimination of a small molecule like HBr and gives us a final product which contains multiple bonds. So this reaction is also called dehydrohalogenation reaction. And why is that? Because a hydrohalogen group is getting essentially eliminated, which is HBr. Let us now discuss the different types of elimination reactions. The first type of elimination reaction is called alpha elimination reaction. So you can know that the two atoms or groups that is getting eliminated are from the alpha carbon, that is nothing but the carbon bearing the functional group. So you can note that an electron deficient reactive species is generated consequently. So let's take an example here. Here we have a saturated compound which is chloroform CHCl3, and when this particular molecule is treated with a strong base like KOH, what we get is CCl3-. So what happens here? OH- is a very strong base and it abstracts a hydrogen which is alpha hydrogen. As you can see, this particular carbon is alpha carbon as it is attached to 3 chlorine atoms. And this OH- abstracts this hydrogen to give us something like this, which is CCl3- ion. Now another atom again gets eliminated from this particular ion, resulting in the formation of CCl2, which is nothing but a highly reactive intermediate called dichlorocarbene. The mechanism is also mentioned here. You can see that OH- abstracts this hydrogen. Why? Because this hydrogen is highly acidic, because you have 3 chlorine atoms which are highly electron withdrawing in nature and draws all the electron towards itself, such that abstraction of this hydrogen becomes very easy. Now consequently, you can see that CCl3- ion is generated, from which again another chlorine atom leaves, giving us CCl2-dichlorocarbene, which is an electron deficient species. So you can also note that the two atoms which are getting eliminated, that is one hydrogen and one chlorine, are from the alpha carbon atoms, and this is essentially why this particular reaction is called alpha elimination reactions. Now you can note that this is a highly reactive intermediate, and this reactive intermediate reacts with other molecules like alkene, in this case ethene, to give us a compound like this as a final product. I hope you are very clear on what are alpha elimination reactions. And now let us go to the second type of elimination reactions called beta elimination reactions. So as the word suggests, the two atoms or groups which are getting eliminated are from the alpha beta carbon atoms. That is, they are from the adjacent carbon atoms, resulting in the formation of a product which has unsaturation or contains multiple bonds. Let's look at an example here. Here we have CH3CH2OH, where hydrogen and OH are placed this way. You can see that OH attached to this carbon becomes an alpha carbon, and consequently this carbon becomes your beta carbon. Now when this particular molecule is subjected to acidic hydrolysis in the presence of a strong acid like H2SO4, OH gets protonated, such that this particular bond shifts here and protonated OH group leaves. That is, after protonation it becomes an H2O group, and when this particular bond shifts here, this particular group becomes a very good leaving group, and with the elimination of water molecule, as you can see here, you get a final product which is nothing but ethene. We can also look at another reaction that you are familiar with, which is dehydrohalogenation. Here again you can see that the starting reactant, which is CH3CH2Br, where bromine is at alpha carbon, can undergo elimination with the elimination of minus HBr to give us alkene. The mechanism is very much similar in the sense that OH minus, which is a strong base, abstracts the hydrogen here from the beta carbon, and the bond shift takes place this way, and consequently bromine gets eliminated, giving us the final product. So here the eliminated product is nothing but a hydrohalogen group, which is nothing but HBr. Let's look at the last step of elimination reaction, which is gamma elimination reaction. Here again you can see that the eliminated groups are from alpha and gamma carbon atoms. Let's take an example here, CH2Br, CH2CH2Br. You can see that the two bromine atoms are at alpha and gamma positions, and when these two bromine atoms get eliminated in the presence of zinc dust or heat, you get a cyclopropane along with ZnBr2. So this is a typical example of gamma elimination reactions. I hope you are very clear on what are elimination reactions, under which conditions it take place, essentially in the presence of a strong base, and what are the different types of elimination reactions, namely alpha, beta and gamma elimination reactions. There are also other types of elimination reactions called E1, E2 reactions, about which you will learn in detail later. Thank you.